These super cheap NILS EXTREME wheels are doing okay also on this not so perfect surface. I'm here at an old Soviet aviation academy, and as you can see, not much renovation has taken place for the last quarter of a century. Having said that, today it belongs to Riga Technical University and some teaching is going on here. Power stops are fine, even though the wheels are grippy 82As. This is what happens when you don't commit. Instead of sliding, the wheels grip. Humbled and humiliated by my failed attempt of power sliding, I make a few more steps to regain confidence. I leave the campus and enter a residential area a few hundred meters down the road. The lack of renovation means loss of natural obstacles. This is just perfect, an empty road with smooth surface and no traffic. Lakeside, a nice place to put the camera and do some drills. This is my second session on NILS EXTREME wheels. They felt okay at the first session, but they feel a bit better now. Bearings take some time to break in, and they definitely do roll better now. Still, they are nowhere close to high quality bearings. I mean, I don't need the best set of bearings when I only do sprints, jumps and turns, and these NILS bearings are good enough for now. But if I did want to go a long distance, I'd rather use a better set of bearings. During the first session, the wheels felt a bit weird. And I think it's because they had this very flat U shape. Now, after I worn them a bit, they have gotten a sharper V shape, which is what I want. They stick like glued to the surface, which is really what I like. I think this is due to the soft 82A rubber. The downside is that they will wear down rather quickly. I'm not sure if I would recommend buying very cheap wheels or not. Obviously, it depends on your budget and preferences. All I can say is that you can have great fun with even the cheapest equipment. More expensive bearings obviously will make you faster and drain less energy. More expensive wheels will last longer. My personal sweet spot is around 30 euros for ILQ7 or SG7 bearings and around 40-50 euro for a set of 85A wheels. Here I'm wearing Rollerblade Spark 84mm skates, but my primary pair is Macroblade 100. They came with 85A Rollerblade Supreme wheels, and they have just about the right amount of grip, and they're also very durable. In 2 months I've only had to rotate them twice, and I expect them to last for a long time. They came with SG9 bearings, and all of them are in good shape still. A few of them did slow down a bit, but some lubricant fixed that. It's always a good idea to apply oil when you rotate the wheels. My only beef with the Macroblade is that the left skate makes a clicking sound, and I haven't been able to locate where it originates from. I guess there's a screw somewhere that needs to be tightened, and please leave a comment if you have an idea about how to fix it. Apart from that, the skates are in perfect shape given all the torture they've endured. Watch my other videos to see a Macroblade 100 in action. I hope you liked this video. Stay tuned for more updates.